hybrid workout today, where we'll do a combination of strength work using weights and some body weight moves. So I would suggest having a lighter and a heavier weight if you have that at your disposal. Doesn't matter if it's kettlebells or dumbbells, just have both close by. We have a couple of moves we use the lighter weight for, a couple of moves we might want to use the heavier weight for. Just have them handy, also a towel and some water, just so you have it all there. All right, let's get warmed up. We're going to start off on our backs with a little knee hug and a twist. So we'll start off hugging our right knee into our chest. Try to push the back of your left leg into the ground. Take a nice deep breath in here. And then on your exhale, bring your right knee halfway across the side of your body. You'll feel this stretch in your outer upper hip area. Take another deep breath in here. And then on your exhale, bring it all the way over to your left side, stacking your right hip on top of the left. Take one more big breath in. Big breath out. And then go ahead and come back to center and switch it up. So have your left hand to your chest, extend your right leg nice and long. Take a nice deep breath in. And then on your exhale, bring your left knee halfway across the right side of your body. Breathe in, breathe out. Take a deep breath in, and then on that exhale, go ahead and bring your left knee all the way over the right side of your body, stacking your left hip on top of the right. Breathing in, breathing out. Inhale and come back to center. Now place both of your heels down on the ground, and then pick up your right foot, cross your right ankle over your left knee. Dig your left heel down into the ground, little ridge pose here, so squeeze your butt cheek here, and then hug your knees into your chest for that cradle. Stay on this side, keep alternating between those two moves, driving your hips up for that bridge, squeeze your left butt cheek, and then go ahead and come down, hug your knees into your chest for that cradle. Get a little glute activation, a little hip opening here on this one. Let's get one more on this side. And then we'll switch it up. So put your right foot down, cross your left ankle over your right knee. Dig your right heel down to the ground. Drive your hips up towards the ceiling. And then come down, hug your knees to your chest for that cradle. Nice stretch on the outer hip area. Let's get one more on this side. And we're good there. All right, go ahead and flip yourself over to a downward facing dog. So you're going to make your way to an upside down V with your body. Curl your toes under, position yourself back. Step your right foot to the outside of your right hand for your Spider-Man pose. Sink your hips down, lift your chest up here. And then go ahead and step back again for that down dog. And take it to the other side. Step your left foot to the outside of your left hand. Sink your hips down, lift your chest up. Get that nice hip stretch in your inner hips and thighs. Step back down dog, nice stretch for your back, for the back of your legs and your back body, and just keep alternating right and left. Try to get your foot all the way to the outside of your hand on this one. Let's get one more each way. And we'll do there. From your down dog, walk your hands back to your feet. Separate your feet a bit wider here. Sit your butt down for an infant squat. So elbows inside knees, butt down, chest up, and then reach your hands up. Go ahead and stand all the way up. Let's do that again. Sit down for your infant squat. Elbows inside knees, chest open here. Reach your arms up, stand up. Sit back down in that infant squat. You can hold it down there for a second or two. And then reach your arms up, stand up. Let's get two more of those. Last one here. And we're good there. All right, we got a little 90-second igniter where we're gonna alternate between two movements. So 15 body weight squats here like this. Once you get 15 body weight squats in, you'll make your way down for 5 push-ups with or without your knees. Lean with your chest, 5 push-ups. All right, let's do this at home. 15 squats. Sit your butt down and back. Driving your legs apart. We're going to try and get 2 rounds. This is 7 for me if you're with me. You can go faster or slower. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Now make your way down and around. Back push-ups. You're going to have your chest in between your hands here. Knees in your chest. Drive up. 3, 4, last one. 5. Make your way back up to your feet. We got those squats again. 15 of them. We're just going to keep alternating between 15 squats, 5 push-ups. We got about 40 seconds left. 7, 8. It's hard for me to count and talk at the same time. So I think I'm on 10. 12, 13, 14, 15. All right, push-ups. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Last one. And 5. All right. We are ready to go at home. Grab your weights if you don't have them. Like I said, it could be a dumbbell or a kettlebell. Lighter, heavier one would be my guess here on these moves for today. Just tap them in. All right. So our first round, we're going to start off with what's called the kettlebell complex. We're going to move right from one move to the next move with this one. You want to try to keep the same weight for all 3 moves. So, starting off with our kettlebell swings. So for this one, you'll start with that weight underneath your nose. Sit your butt down, keep your chest up, hike it back, drive your hips forward, squeeze your butt. So we're going to do swings for 40 seconds here. If you're not a swinger, that's fine. You can do RDLs. So feet hip distance apart, slide your butt back, chest over your toes, drive your hips forward, squeeze your butt. Most likely the heavier of your 2 weights for this one. Then I'll tell you to switch. You're gonna pop this guy up to your chest. We got goblet squats. Elbows in, sit your butt down, drive right back up. Drive your knees apart at the bottom, squeezing your core. Last but not least, reverse lunges. You can keep that weight at your chest, or you can always put your weight off to the side if you need to for this one. You'll step back, rounding through the front foot, alternating right and left here. Again, if you want to add that weight, you can hold it up at your chest. So that's our first complex that we're going to go through. You want to try to use that same weight for all 3 of those moves. After that, our little rest break, before we do it all again, you'll make your way to your back for what's called a straight leg bridge. So we'll dig your heels down into the ground here, lift your butt up, and you're going to drive all the way up, and then you're going to hold this for 30 seconds, drop back down. If you need to, you can hold a regular bridge. You can bend your knees, hold a regular bridge. So that's our rest break. And then we'll do it all again. So we have 3 rounds of that kettlebell complex, which includes swings, squats, and reverse lunges. And then we're going to hold that straight leg bridge for 30 seconds at the end, or a regular bridge. That's our rest break. All right, well, are you ready to do this? I'm ready to do this. We're going to do it together. Grab that heavier weight. Kettlebell, most likely on this one. Set it up without a height, and let's do it. Drive your hips forward, squeeze your butt at the top. Remember, you're swinging or you're already up. Either one. You're ending up again, standing plank in these swings. Squeeze your butt and your core at the top. Drive your hips back. So there's a little bend in your knees, but most of the work here is happening in your hips and your butt. Let's get 2 more. And we're moving on. All right, we bring that guy up to your chest here. Take a couple deep breaths. And we're going into that squat. Sit your butt down and back. Drive right back up. Push the outer edges of your feet, knees come right, elbows come right inside your knees. That's it, everyone. Stay with me. Got about 10 more seconds here. Give me 2 more. Last one. And we're your belly's tight. Protect your back on these. Two more. Last one.
Make sure you do that full extension. If you want to make it harder, lift your arms off the ground like me, and then reaching towards the ceiling as you grab your hips up. Or you can have your hands down. You need it for a little support today. We're already over half, but we've got 10 seconds. You can do it. Two more. Last one. All right, at home, that's the end of round one. High five to you at home. Grab some water. I'll tell you what we got coming up for our second round. I'm going to take a little sip myself. All right, so you'll probably need your lighter and your heavier weight for this next round. We're going to start off with our single arm gorilla rows. So you'll start with that kettlebell in between your feet. We're going to do all right side and then all left side. So for this one, you want to sit your butt down and back, chest stays over your hips. You're going to feel the energy and the work being done in your hips here as you hold this pose. Then you're going to grab that bell and you're going to row. So your elbow's going to come right to your inner hip crease. You're going to maintain that gorilla position. We'll do all right side, and then I'll tell you to stand up, rest a minute, and we'll switch it up and do the left side. So you want to avoid turning your torso as you row that weight. That's our first one. After that, we have a single arm curl to a press. So this is where that lighter weight is going to come in handy. So you'll start off on the right side, nice tall standing plank. So you'll give me one curl, so you'll bring that weight up to your shoulder, and then drive that same weight up overhead. Maintain that plank so you're not leaning back to get that weight up overhead. Nice and solid. We'll do the right side and then we'll do the left side. And then last but not least, we got lateral bear curls within our square. So, or within your space at home. So, and within my square, within your space. Make sure you have some room here. You're going to find a bear plank. Knees are right underneath your hips. They cover about 2 inches from the ground. And then you'll crawl yourself to the right side. And then take it back over to the left. Trying to keep those knees above the ground. Maintaining control, hugging your core. So that's our next three moves for this next round. Starting off with a single arm gorilla row on the right side. So you want to grab your heavier of your two weights here. Start with it between your feet. Getting ready here by sitting our butt down, belly tight, shoulders over hips. And let's do it. Rolling it out on the right side. Keeping this gorilla pose. Making sure you're not twisting your torso. All shoulder blades and upper back. Doing this movement. Squeeze and pause at the top. Two more on this side. Last one. And stand up and reset. We're gonna do the left side now. You can shake those legs out a little bit. Make sure you get a little rest for your back. Set it up, and let's do it left side. Little pause, you're not going too fast here. Keep your booty down. If you need to stand up and reset, feel free to do so, and then just go right back into it. Last one here, and we're good there. All right, put that heavier weight off to the side. Grab your lighter weight, curl to press. Set it up, and let's do it. One curl, push that weight up overhead. Reset. Curl, keep your elbow on your side. Drive it up overhead. Keep your low ribs towards your hips on this one. Big exhale drives it up. Keeps those low ribs locked in. Making sure that elbow's not traveling too far away from your body on this one. Got 10 seconds to go. Stay with me at home. One more on this side. And we're switching up. I'll give you a little side view at home. Setting it up to that left side. And let's do it. One curl. Drive it up overhead. Reset. Curl and push. And let's do it. Chest up, butt down. Grow it out. Maintaining control of your torso. No twisting here. We got time for about three more on this side. Last one. And shake it out for a second. Take a moment here. Woo! Feel that right side again. And let's do it on the left. Three more. One. keep your wrist neutral, and then drive back. Either one of those options is fine. Whatever's going to give you most control, keep your elbow at your side. on the right. Just make sure you have your weight close by. Set it up here on the right side. Roll onto your back. And let's do it, right side. Big exhale as you push it up. Elbow comes 45 degrees from your torso. Belly stays down. Drive it up. You need to take that opposite hand on your chest muscle. Feel it working. Inhale, slow control lower. Exhale, drive it up. Yeah, keep your low back on the ground. It's going to have a little arch there. That's natural. You just want to keep pushing through, making your chest work here. You got 10 seconds on this side. Let's get two more. And the last one. Awesome. Remember, get that kettlebell. You're rolling onto your side. Bring it up and around. Curling onto the left side. Set it up left side. And let's do it. Take your time. Little tap and a drop. Remember, you take that opposite hand. Feel your chest working. On that left arm, on that working side. You got about 10 seconds on this side. So time for about 5 to 7 more, depending on your weight and how heavy you're going. Last two here. Last one. And we're good there. All right, skull crushers. So again, if you grab a different weight, you can use the same weight. You got a dumbbell holding the ends. Lock it in. And let's do it. Bend and straight. Bend and straight. Feel the back of your arms lighting up here. And not allowing your shoulders to move. Just your elbows. So we're really isolating your triceps. How are your arms doing at home? Mine are burning. We're already halfway through. Stay with me. Come on. We got time for about 3 more. 1, 2, last one, and 3. All right, so that was your weight. Put it off to the side. Tricep push-ups. So make your way to your low plank. Elbows right over your shoulders, under your shoulders, they're right here, they're over. And that's it. Go ahead, push the ground away. Tap them back down. Try to get both elbows to come down and up at the same time. If you need a break, rest in a low plank. You can do it with or without your knees. Again, you can drop your knees down here. Same concept. Try to push both elbows up at the same time. Bring them down at the same time. 10 seconds, come on. 2 more. Last one. And that's round one. We got 2 rounds to go at home. I know you can do it. Shake it out. Woo! All right, we're gonna start off with that single arm floor press on the right side. Make your way to your right side, fetal position. Roll onto your back, and let's do it. Make sure you're giving yourself some space between your shoulder and your ear. Elbow's gonna tap down about 45 degrees, and then drive back up. Let's get it done. We're already halfway through our second set almost. Come on. We've got about 15 seconds. Let's get three more. One. Two. Last one. Three. All right. Sit up with no weight. Put it off to the side. Tricep push-ups. Arms are feeling jelly-like. All right. Set it up. Shoulders over your elbows here. And let's do it. Push the ground away. Drive right back down. Push. And bring it down. No shame in grabbing your knees if you need to. Still going to get those triceps lit up. Roll on your back a bit. Feet down. Low back on the ground.